ओम ज्ञानतिविरान्द्रस्सज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुर्मीतं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। गुरवे गुरुचन्द्राय राधिकावे तदारे कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय सद्भक्ताय वंशाकल्पतरुर्वश्च कृपासिन्धुरेव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौरभक्तवृन्द हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे।
सो आई विल रीड वन श्लोक फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवत गीता अबाउट आत्म तत्व और सोल। Soul and body completely are different things. Yesterday I also told. So in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says to Arjuna, Na jana jayate mriyate va kadachit nayan bhutta bhavita vano bhuva ajunittam sasvato ayam purano na annate annamane sarire। Jivatma neither takes birth nor dies, nor does he experience repeated creation or growth. He is unborn, eternal and ever existing. Though primeval, he remains ever youthful. When the body is destroyed, the Jivatma is not destroyed. Is the simple meaning of this verse. So Vishwanath Chakravarti path in this verse very clearly explained. The eternal nature of Jivatma has been established in this sloka. He is beyond birth and death and is eternal and ever existing. He is not destroyed even the body is destroyed consequently. The Jivatma is devoid of all the six types of transformation, birth, duration of existence, growth, procreation and diminution and death. In our Katha Upanishad also explained this. This body is why jayate asti vardhayate and apakhayate and then vinashyate. Jayate means to growth. This body grows. When you are small baby, now youth and young, then old, then one day this body grows. Jayate apakhayate also destroy one. But Atma soul, that is called unborn. Just soul is the part and parcel of Lord, this thing. And you cannot to realize this soul with your material senses. And your material body you can touch to him also. Understand, doctor?
Yeah.
In your body, you can touch the soul. This thing is possible. When you touch the soul to soul? When? When Atma and Atma, ek Atma, this is a little cup person. When you have no body, that means when you will get the transcendental body, that time your transcendental body, transcendental senses, that time you can soul to soul. This is the process. And when you will go the transcendental world also, abode of Lord, when we will go the abode of Lord, that is called Bhagavad Dham. And that time we can touch soul to soul. As like Subal Sridham. Their body also are transcendental. Subal and Sridham, they are embracing Krishna. That is called one soul kissing to another soul. Because there is no any material or gross body. In this material world, we have three types of bodies. What is that? Gross body, subtle body, and transcendental body. That is called Atma. The gross body, just you are looking, this is the gross body. And made by the five
gross
elements. This thing, you know, this standard. Our subtle body, in this gross body also another subtle body. That is called, four elements are there. Man, buddhi, ahankar and chitta. Mind, intelligence, egos and heart. That is called the subtle. And inside the subtle body, then another body. That is called atmasari. Actually, inside means is what? Not touch. Even the subtle body never touch the transcendental body.
Spiritual.
That is called spirit of soul. Because spirit of soul completely detached from this thing, subtle body and gross body. This is the thing. So in this way, in this verse, Krishna, he discourses about Atma Tattva, Soul Tattva. And that soul is very minute. Balagra sata bhagasya, satadha kalpitasya cha, bhago jivasya anantasya kalpate. That means, how the soul, very minute, molecular. Given example, balagra sata bhagasya, if you cut the one tip of the hair in 100 pieces. Then again, one part of the tip of the hair, again also what? Divided 100 pieces. That the shape of the soul. The size of the soul. Then very more than molecular. As the English word, balagra sata bhagasya, satadha kalpitasya cha, bhago jivo sa anantasya kalpate. And jiva is also ananta, innumerable.
And soul is very suchma, but it is spread to whole body, whole self, everywhere.
Yeah. This is given example of Vedanta says, jatha da lukavat. You are right. Jatha da lukavat. Jatha da lukavat, this and as like you also put one bulb, light, one corner of your house, but the whole house room completely
illuminated.
In the same way, soul resides one part of the body, but whole body also
illuminated.
Active. What do you
know? Conscious.
What is called? Active. This way. What?
Energized.
This way. Energy. How does it give energy? So where soul is living? Which part of the body soul remains and this body is working? Maybe your question will come. Your hands, hand, leg, mouth, ears, where is the soul? Where? आपके घर के एक कोने में लाइट रख दिया. ठीक उसी प्रकार आत्मा शरीर के एक जगह में स्थित है. जथा आलोकवत, जथा आलोकवत. Vedanta Sutra, according to Vedanta Sutra, Atma remains one part of one corner of the body, limbs of the body. And as like the light, if you put the light one corner of the body, but whole room is one. In the same way, soul resides one part of this body. Not everywhere. But whole body also. And creative and conscious and active. Well, so Vedanta explained this way. soul and remains three places in this body. And understand?
Yeah.
Where? In our eyes, in our throat, in our heart. These are three places he remains. That is called Jagrata, Susupti and Nidra. Jagrata means when you are wake up, and that time soul resides in your eyes. Now you are
awake.
Now where is your soul?
In the eyes.
Vedanta is in this world. And when you are taking rest, not completely sleep and not completely wake up, and that time your Atma remains in your throat. Kanthadesa. Kanthadesa sthita. Chakshu kanthadita hridastha. And when you are sleeping, completely dark, deep sleep, gavira nidra, deep sleep, and that time Atma remains in your heart. The heart is as like lotus. That is called Hit Kamal. Kamal means lotus. Our heart is that as like lotus, in the inside the lotus of heart, then Atma, soul remains in there. This way. And Paramatma, super soul, he remains everywhere. He is watching. And he is watching just. Because different, because this transcendental things you cannot express in your words, and you cannot express any material example. So different Upanishad gives a different example about how Atma remains in the body of the human being. Das Varna Suja Samana Vrikka Prajissa Jati. This body is as like a tree. In this tree, two branches, left and right. In this left and right, two branches and two birds are there living. Actually, Atma Pakshi, and it's called Paramatma Pakshi. The birds of soul are the birds of super soul. In the middle of the birds and super soul, one black screen, that is called Maya. That is called
Maya.
The illusory potency of Lord. But super soul, Paramatma, he is looking what the Jivatma is doing. But Jivatma cannot see Paramatma. Because sa mujjhamano, sa chako siti, sa mujjhamano. In Katha Upanishad, sa chako siti. He is suffering his own previous foot of action. So now Atma is as like a fainted position, as like what is called coma.
Coma
position. Coma means is what? Doctor not saying dead. Still he is also what?
Alive.
Alive. But he all senses not working. So in the same way Atma and now in this as we coma position, not doing anything. That is actually, you can say, as like fainted position, Atma. Now Atma here, fainted position. This. Or, but Atma rejects this body, but all our limbs and body and working. Even our gross body and subtle body also working. Do that. Some miracle this. This is going on this way. So saying in this way, no jayate muryater ba bhavita bhaje. But in this sloka there is no special word. Who knows to him, but not so easy to understand about him. Because this Atma is very minute. Even sometimes Muni, Rishi, Yogis, they can't understand all these things. And how to know to about him? The question is, how will know about him? And Nangatma Pravachana Labhu No Medhaya No Bahuna Sutena Jame Bhisi Binute Tena Labha Tasai Satma Vibrunute Tanusama Nangatma Pravachana Labhu No Medhaya No Bahuna Sutena. Giving many explanation of the scriptures or study Ved Upanishad or perform many kinds of austerity, yoga, tapasya, no one can realize to him. When we surrender to Guru and Krishna, then by the mercy of Guru and Krishna, then he will be self-manifest in our hearts, then we realize about to him. This time. So saying, Nayanatma, Prachanrabbo, no Moja, no Bhuna, Suteno, Jame Vaisi Vinuti Tena Labha Tasai Satma Vibrunte Tanusama. But when he will give mercy? This is the point. This point is there. Two things are saying. What is that? Kevala. Surrender. When we surrender to Guru and Krishna. So again Krishna says, Tadvidhi Pranipatino Puripasteno Sevaya Upadikshan Tirte Gyanino Gyan Tattva Darshina. Tattva Darshi means highest philosopher, that is called self-realization person, Atma Gyani, who has realization about Lord. Maybe your question will come, how will you know he has realization about Lord, him not? Maybe many questions will come, you can ask. So how will you know that this person has Atma Gyani? How will you know? This is true. How will you know you are doctor? How will you know you are lawyer? Question coming many. How will you know you are doctor? But how will you know you are lawyer?
Studied in the college and got certificate.
No, how will I know you are doctor?
I don't know, difficult to know. By look, difficult to know.
External, if I see you are doctor, but here is no stamp in your
forehead.
I am doctor, I am lawyer. This one?
Yes.
How will you know? Samsana Prabhu is doctor. This true. No, here you know any stamp. Stamp in your paper, certificate you have in your
cupboard.
In your room.
Box.
Yes. When I will associate with him and discuss something, that time I will realize. Another thing, when I will go with him, if I have
opportunity,
if I have any disease, patient, then I will go, then he will give medicine, and I will see his also external activity also. False doctor, he good, perfect doctor. I will see also, because this is my external visit, vision, this thing. Then when you will give medicine, part medicine, when you will cure from the disease, that time faith will come, oh, doctor.
Good doctor.
Good doctor. Before, maybe, belief, maybe not believe, there is another thing. But when I will meet with him, and talking and discuss this thing, then slowly, slowly my faith will come. Not one day faith will come. The truth. So in the same way, how will you know his self-realized person who has realization? When I will meet with him, then slowly, slowly, I listen Hari Katha. And also, same super soul resides in my heart, also super soul Paramatma resides in your heart. Then slowly, slowly, The same Paramatma will give inspiration in your heart. Two things will come. Not only blind following. Not blind. You slowly, slowly, your realization will come. This is the process. Another thing is also, but how will you know? Yoha jasya harir dasya karmana manasa gira niklasa vyavasthitanam jivana mukta sa ucchati. Jaya Vedan Bhakti Vrinda Thakur quoted this verse from the Upanishad, Sanskrit book. Yoha jasya harir dasya. One who thinks everything belongs to Krishna. And he always thinking, I am the servant of Lord Sri Hari. Simple. Yoha jasya harir dasya karmana manasa gira. Karmana manasa gira with his body, mind and speech, always we serve to Lord. This is the process. That is called the symptom of self-realization person. He completely detached this material world. And who give him good name or who should have bad name, he is not looking. And he is always what? To remember his Krishna. And serve his Ishtadev Guru and Krishna. Govinda Dhamo Dharmadhavirti Govinda Dhamo Dharmadhavirti Govinda Dhamo Dharmadhavirti Govinda Dhamo Dharmadhavirti. So I am saying because in this way you can realize he is self-realization person. But always many cheating people. Just a few months before, when I was in India, Mathura, one person, he came in Mathura. He told he is a representative of one insurance company. You see? And he took one big, he also had one big house, big palace, every month. He paid Indian money more than 20,000 rupees per month. And in Mathura, he rented. Okay? Understand? And also very nice chair and everything very nicely. And he advertisement, oh, I'm this company's representative. Okay? This thing. So you have to put your money in insurance company. So people, you know, Mathura, some people, they are very simple people, but mostly he used to go the village people. And you preach to them, oh, you put your money in the insurance, you get back this money. And people, faith, people are coming in his church and saying, oh, this is my office, this is very nice. Faith coming. So put the money in their insurance company. Then after 6 months, suddenly he
disappeared.
And he completely disappeared. And then people came, no sign, nothing. And owner of the said, oh, he left. His agreement within 6 months. And 6 months finished, he went out. Finished. And he took all
money.
Then people, oh my God, what you do? This is called the, blind
faith.
The spiritual day thing.
By looking at house and
that will be external. So our Shastra is saying no blind faith. Faith should be with the scripture, Shastriya Pramana. Mahaprabhu said, whatever we say, you have to give the evidence from the scriptures. And so saying, Yoha jasya harir dasya karmana manasa gira niklasa vyavasthitanam jivana mukta sa ucchate. One who completely surrendered to Guru and Krishna. Understand? And only things, I am the servant of Lord Sri. Everything belongs to Krishna. Is coming or going?
Nothing. Nothing.
क्या तू लेकर के आया थे क्या तू लेकर के जाएगा फॉर थिंग्स डिड यू ब्रिंग एंड फॉर थिंग्स विल गो
विथ
व्हेन यू डाई दिस इज ट्रू सो दिस इज दैट इज कॉल्ड दैट पर्सन ऑफ आत्मदर्शन Then, one who takes darshan to atma, so darshan, then he will be absorbed in this way. Not attached, not detached also. Then, who is coming? Okay, who is going? Good. He is not thinking anything. And he thinks, who is my enemy and who is my
friend?
Friend. No me disoste, no me priya. Who is my friend? Or who is my enemy. These are things. Actually, only thinking everybody also is my friend. He's not thinking anybody is my enemy. Why? Because everything belongs to God. All we are the son of one God. All we are the
son of God.
Son of God. This is our relationship. According our body, according our different material conception, we are thinking he is my enemy and he is my friend. That is your material conception. Jada vichar, that is called material conception. Understand? Our atma vichar, transcendental conception is that all we are related with God, Bhagavan. This is the thing. Not other things. And there, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
So we have Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad in this slogan very clearly explained. When you realize about our soul, Atma Tattva, that time we were not happy or we were not unhappy. Sukhesu dusukhesu vigatamana dukhesu vigatastriya vitarago bhayakrodha sthitadhi munira ucchate. Srimad Bhagavad Gita Krishna. Dukhesu udvignamana. If any kinds of distress will come, will never be disturbed. His mind will never disturb you. Sukhesu vigato. If that any kinds of happiness will also not disturb. Sukhe dukhe samakritva lava lava jaya jo. Sukhe dukhe in his happiness and unhappiness. Or jaya ajo means receive or lose. He's not thinking anything. Because this is the coming and going in this material world. And this is the... In this material world, we are getting and one day we will go out. And coming and going, that is a depend on our previous foot of action. Sometimes money coming and sometimes money also going. What to do? If you are a businessman, always money is not in your hand. Sometimes business going up, or sometimes business going
down.
What will do? The water of the river. Sometimes high tide and sometimes
low
tide. When you realize this tattva, atma tattva, this is the symptom. This is the process. And when you achieve to Lord, then you realize that time you will get the transcendental body. That was very, very nice. Then that time, according your own desire, you can manifest that body also. Because that body is called the Bhagavad Seva Pojogi body. Right? That body will get how to serve to Lord. How did you get this? That body is called
Bhagavad Seva, how to start to this body. Listen. And according your melus rasad, and you get at the body. And Lord, and you can start to Lord. Male body, female body, you will get there. Not this material. This material body is the male body, female body. But in transcendental world, you will get that types of body. Lord will give that. Then everything is arranged for you. You have everything just by the Jogamaya will manifest. Then this. So Atma Tattva, this way. Then. So Sukadeva Goswami in Bhagavad Krishna says, this is very confident. People cannot understand this. Then you cannot touch your soul because they are transcendent. Then again, in this presence of the time, in this time, according to your conditional stage and in this material world, you cannot embrace your soul. I saw
you. But you can feel. You can feel.
What your? What do you feel?
Like.
You feel only your, listen, you feel only your settled mind.
Yeah.
You cannot feel with your Atmana according to your present situation. In your present situation, you cannot feel nothing. All you feel is this body and mind. Sure.
Guru, I do meditate every day in the morning. I am not body, I am not Sudhir, I am a pure soul. I am pure soul. In that way, you don't feel your body, but you feel as a soul, pure soul. Is it possible?
It's possible, not in one day. This takes time.
Yeah.
And it takes time.
Yeah.
And that time you completely forget everything.
Everything.
If you once forget everything, that time thinking, not even this body, not this house. You are not thinking, this is my wife, this is my son, this is my daughter. Even that you will forget how to arrange your daughter's marriage ceremony. Do you understand this thing? Because that is called the Atma Anubhuti will come. Understand this thing? Now we are practicing. This is good idea. You have to practice. I am not this body. I am not this mind. This is true. You can practice. But not only practice, you try to realize. When realization will come, that complete solution. That give an example. One mango, green mango, very small green mango. Same mango when become mature, that is called half ripen. A same mango completely ripen, then the different shape and different activities. When the small mango, green mango, you cannot separate three things.
Skin.
Seed. And also?
Flesh.
Mango.
Flesh.
Same mango when ripened, and that time only you can peeling. Understand this thing? But seed and also flesh also are attached with the seed. A same mango when completely, absolutely ripened, that time you can separate three things. Seed, flesh, make juice, take out, and also
skin.
Three stages. In the same way, in our bhajana dasa, three stages of our bhajana dasa. Remember to tell things. That is called sadhana bhakti. Bhava bhakti and prema bhakti. Maybe new words you are listening.
Sadhan bhakti, prema bhakti.
Sadhan bhakti, bhava bhakti, or prema bhakti. In the sadhan bhakti, in the beginning of your bhajan and sadhan, you cannot separate your body, mind, and soul. This is sadhan bhakti. Just to practicing, this is true, advanced. And when you come in the stage of bhava bhakti, that time you can separate your atma sarir and soul. Atma sarir and
स्थूल शरीर दिस बट नॉट कंप्लीटली बट व्हेन यू कम इन द प्रेमा भक्ति दैट टाइम यू कैन सेपरेट थ्री एंड द ग्रॉस बॉडी सेटल बॉडी एंड स्पिरिचुअल बॉडी दैट मीन वन हु अचीव्स इन द स्टेज ऑफ प्रेम ओनली दे कैन सेपरेट थ्री थ्री बॉडीज एंड योगीज ओनली दे कैन सेपरेट फ्रॉम देयर सेटल बॉडी टू ग्रॉस बॉडी दे कैन नॉट सेपरेट एंड आत्मशरी बिकॉज दे आर आत्म स्टिल इन साइड सेटल बॉडी अंडरस्टैंड ओनली वन हु अचीव्स इन द स्टेज ऑफ प्रेम प्रेम स्टेज दे कैन सेपरेट थ्री This is the process. These things, discourses in our scripture, very clearly. You one who realize this thing. Yogis, only their yoga process they can separate.
Gross body
to settle body. Give an example. Shankaracharya. You have heard the name of Shankaracharya?
Yes.
Who preached the impartialism of Mayavada philosophy, Advaitavada philosophy. Because Shankaracharya is not different from Lord Shiva, Shankara Shankara Sakshat. Shankaracharya is not different from
Shankara
Lord Shiva. Because Krishna himself told to him, he Shankar, to you preach the impartialism, Mayavada philosophy. Aham Brahmasmi, this. Shankarji himself told to Devi Parvati, that means once Parvati Devi asked to Lord Shankar, oh my husband, why are you to making illusion to the human being? Why? Aham Brahmasmi, you are not Brahma. But why you are saying this? And that time Shankar told, hey Devi Parvati, this is not my fault. And my master Krishna, he gave me order. Hey Shankar, you preach this impartialism. And this is the evidence in the Shastra. मयावादम अशुशास्त्र प्रच्छन्न बौद्ध उच्यते मयादुप्रक्ता देवी हे देवी पार्वती आई एम प्रीचिंग दिस इम्पर्सनलिज्म इम्पर्सनलिज्म बाय द ऑर्डर ऑफ माय मास्टर लॉर्ड कृष्णा दिस इज नॉट माय फॉल्ट बिकॉज द डेमन्स दे डिस्टर्ब माय लॉर्ड सो लॉर्ड टोल्ड मी यू प्रीच Aham Brahma, I am Brahma, then demon, they will be what? Think you, I am Brahma. So, they will
be. No need Krishna.
No need Krishna.
This.
So now Shankaracharya, just time with Shankaracharya, when he was in this material, he was great also yogi. And yoga process. You read one book, Guru Pakpadam, Pagan Kesavasana, that is called Beyond Nirvana. This book. Very nice book. And Beyond Nirvana, a powerful book, and all Shankaracharya's life history is there. Shankaracharya, when he was youth, then he was trying to conquer all the intellectual person. He asked, fight my argument with the scriptures, all you write, you defeated. Then Shankaracharya, he came in South India, one place, That is, his name was Kumaril Bhatta. Kya naam bola?
Kumaril
Bhatta. He was very intelligent person. And but he told, no, you also to discuss with me philosophy. Then Shankaracharya, he is Shankar. Who can fight with him? Very powerful. Shankaracharya means Shankar himself. Very quick, he defeated. Then his wife asked to him, oh, according to our Indian Vedic culture, wife is called the half body of the husband, that's your Ardhangini. Indian culture, wife is called the half body of the husband, so Ardhangini. So you defeat my husband, they mean half, not completely. You have to defeat me also. That means you have to talk with me, discuss with me. Shankaracharya, he was sannyasi. No, I don't want to argument with the ladies. But if you don't really, so my husband can't to sign defeat. Can't to sign.
Except
this. But Shankaracharya finally did, okay, though I am sannyasi, no harm. I have to discuss about the scriptures with you. Then time that, what subject do you want to speak with me? What subject? Any subject that you can. And that time, the wife of Kumari, she was very intelligent. That time ladies are not ogamini, not ignorant. They are also very intelligent. They knew many Ved, Puran, Upanishad, Shastra. That time, the wife of Muni Rishis, they are very intelligent. Understand? General people thinking, oh, ladies are less intelligent, people are thinking. But this is not true. All ladies are not less intelligent. And as I, what is called? Arundhati, the wife of Vasishtha, Arundhati and the other. That time, very powerful they are ladies. Not ordinary, that time they are very powerful. That means they knew all Ved, Puran, Upanishad. In the same way, the wife of Kumaril Bhatta, she was very powerful ladies. She knew all Ved, Puran, Upanishad, as like her husband. So Shankaracharya, he asked, what subject do you want to talk with me? And that time, she told, I want to discuss about with sex. Oh my God. What did he say? This word.
Love.
No, material
thing. Okay.
Because this is not spiritual things. That time they are discussed about Shastra. That is called Kama Shastra. Spiritual sex, this thing. That time Shankaracharya is afraid. How possible? I am sannyasi. And complete also had brahmachari. I don't know about the this function. How possible? But she told, you told me choose which Shastra. I told this Shastra. Kama Shastra. Understand? You have to sign. That time Shankaracharya would say, I am brahmachari, how far I am sannyasi. Brahmacharya, how fast will discuss with you? And also, this Shastra also here. Kama Shastra discuss with the ladies, how possible? So if you are not possible, so sign. You defeat. In that time Shankaracharya said, no. Okay, wait. Give me 2 months. After 2 months, I can argue with you, this Shastra, Kama Shastra. That time Shankaracharya thinking, I am brahmachari and sannyasi, I have no idea about the function of the ladies and their sentiments, activities. What to do now? Then Shankaracharya Johan said, Shankaracharya is a yogi. How yogis, they also separate their gross body and subtle body. So Shankaracharya called all his disciples. They listen. 2 months, you have, and very carefully protect my this body, gross body. After 2 months, I will return back this body. So they are Shankaracharya, just a yoga. Yoga is just the yoga dar. He came out. This body, subtle body. Then that time, his subtle body came out and entered in the one body of king. That time the king died, about died. That time king died, then king's atma left the body, then Shankaracharya's settled body entered the king's body. And that time king's body was going to the burning. Just also put on the
fire.
About to the fire, just they are going to put fire. As Shankaracharya entered, then within king alive and everybody afraid, maybe ghost. Or we committed, maybe king get conscious me. And everybody running and there. Shankaracharya, the same tune of king, he called to them, no, no. And I did not give up my body. Just I became unconscious, you think I left the body. Actually not this. That time everybody returned back. Now he returned back his home, king. Actually, who is acting? Shankaracharya himself. You read this Shankaracharya life history. And come back and enter his own body. And there he again discussed about the wife of with the wife of Kumarila Bhatta, this Kama Shastra, they will defeat. I am saying because in this way, yogis only they can separate their gross body to subtle body. Then this is the process. Then this is the process. Are those who are pure devotee, according to the desire of Krishna, just in their trance, samadhi, they can also separate three body, gross body, subtle body, and spiritual body. Then, you know about Jesus also, when the crucified.
Crucified.
He also what? Left his body. And after a few days, 7 days, again returned back and he met with his followers. Then, because he was a devotee also. Then, so in this way, those are devotees, if they want, they can also separate three body. Gross body, subtle body, and spiritual body. But general people cannot do this thing. Generally, yogis are with their mystic power. Yogis, in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna also explained this way, yoga darshan. How yogis, according to the yoga process, they separate this body, gross body and subtle body. This is different process. Srimad Bhagavad Gita, 18th chapter, discourses about 18 types of yogas. Karma yog, Gyan yog, Bhakti yog, Sannyas yog, Raj yog, Gujjo Vidya yog, different yogas. 18 yogas. But topmost yoga, that is called Bhakti yoga. Three yogas is prominent, there is Karma yoga, Jnana yoga, and Bhakti yoga. So Krishna says to Arjuna, hey Arjuna, listen, my lord. Karmi bho adhiko yogi, yogi bho bhakti mato adhiko. The Jnanis, they are higher than Karma yoga. That means Karma yoga, Jnana yoga is higher than Karma yoga. Bhakti yoga is the higher than Jnana yoga. So tasmat, hey Arjuna, you try to become my devotee, bhakti, bhakti yoga. Because na sadati mang yogam na sankha dharma uddhava na sabdas tapostago jatha bhaktir mamo orjita. Krishna says, hey Uddhava, na sadati mang yogam. By the purpose of yoga process, different yogas, and except bhakti yoga, other yogas, not can attain to my abode. Then, even the tapasya, austerities, no one attain. Only jatha bhakti mamo urjita, only the practice of bhakti yoga, and very easy, attain to me. What is the bhakti yoga is very simple also. Nyabhi karma nasosti pratyavadana vidyate. Sarvam apyasya dharmasya tayate mahato bhayat. This bhakti yogi, with little bit of practice bhakti yoga, you will be delivered from this ocean, the material existence. And all your sinful activities were destroyed. And this bhakti yoga, eternal and transient. What is that bhakti yoga? What is the bhakti yoga?
To praise God, Lord, and
just simply chant his holy names and follow the four principles. Not other than this. आपका और कुछ करना नहीं पड़ेगा. केवल चार नियम के जिन कोई पालन करता है, नो ईट मीटिंग, नो गैम्बलिंग, एंड नो अरिकॉल इंटॉक्सिकेशन आर नो लिवसेस, दिस द फोर थिंग्स यू कैन, एंड सिंपली जस्ट प्लेन लिविंग एंड हाई थिंकिंग. हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे,
हरे राम
राम राम. So Srimad Bhagavatam, Ajamil, what did he? Bhajan and Sada. Just he chanted his son's name Narayan. He chanted his son's name Narayan. Or he delivered from this material and completely free from all kinds of sinful activities. How is the purpose of this? Bhakti yoga means chant Lord's holy names. Not other than this. Ajamil, he was very sinner. Mahapapi. There are many kinds of sinful activity. But Ajamil, he committed all kinds of sinful activities. But one thing, in his life, he did not commit offense, lotus feet of Vaishnava, Vaishnava Parat. For this, very quick, holy names, Namavas, manifested in his chant. Namavas means this emblem is the holy names. Just he chanted his son's name, Narayan, Narayan, Narayan. He gave his son's name, Narayan. And every time he chanted, Narayan, come here, Narayan, do thee, Narayan, 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 Narayan. And at the end of his life, then he also called his son's name Narayan. At a time, two persons came, Vishnu Dutas and Jama Dutas. Both came. But Vishnu Dut, they also told to Jama Dut, no, Ajami he chanted Lord's name, Bhagavat Naam. But he is not qualified, he did not go to Jama Loka. So this Bhakti Yoga means simply Bhakti Yoga. Shravan, Kirtan, Smaran, but this main Bhakti Yoga they call Bhagavat Naam, Smaranam, remembrance the sweet names, sweet holy names, Bhagavat Madhura Naam. It will do nothing. Eating, sleeping, any time, you can chant Lord's holy names. You have no time. You say, Maharaj, I have no time to chant holy names. Any time, any moment. When you just go to sleep bed and take a japamala, one round you chant, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Simply, chant Lord's holy name. Bhakti yoga is simple. Then you will perform all kinds of sinful activities. And if you more and more try to advance, then read Shastra, scriptures. Knowledge of the scriptures, Shastra, Gyan, and associated with Sadhu, Guru, Vaishnava, then step by step advance and then you go to Goloka Vrindavan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. You want to buy that one, you see. He is taking.
No, not at the moment. We'll do the chanting. That will take only 10 minutes.
Oh, yeah.
Pardon?
10 minutes, okay. Yeah.
We'll do another half an hour.
Okay.
You
okay.
Have to take appointment. You can't just go. Okay.
Yeah? got to listen, we'll chant.
Okay. Balo Radhe 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 Jagai Jati Radhe 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 Radhe
Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.